Good afternoon. I want to thank you for your partnership in parks. When I was first elected in 2014, we were able to secure $35 million for the East River Esplanade, and we were working together, and we were looking forward to breaking ground on fixing the Esplanade between 88th and 90th Street, where you had identified a severe weakness. And in the intervening a little less than three years, there now is a big hole in the city park behind the mayor's house. And during the preliminary budget, based on numbers that, in all fairness, I received from Parks Department, that there's $169 million in need to keep what happened to the mayor from happening to everybody else, going from East Harlem down to East Midtown. I am grateful to receive $100 million for my district from 61st to 53rd, but we need to care for the existing infrastructure. So I guess I'm disappointed that the $125 million that you referenced in your testimony does not cover the East River Esplanade. And I guess I wanted to touch on two facts. One, will you commit to the $169 million that Parks needs to keep this park from falling into the East River? And in addition, what can Parks do to ensure that when you identify that there is a weakness, that that weakness does not progress to a point that it falls in while we're waiting for a real repair? And I'm against Band-Aids, but I'd like to make sure that things don't just fall in.
All right. What I can commit to is that there's $41 million in phase one, and I believe another $25 million for phase two, and we can commit to those two phases. The 169 They were already funded. The 169 you referred to would be a phase three that has not been committed, and that is something I have to work with both the mayor's office and OMB to make the determination for the 169. But the process worked. EDC did a study. They found vulnerable areas, including the one you had mentioned, where a portion of the Esplanade fell. We had advanced it, and we're about a month away from starting that work, because we have identified that as one of the vulnerable areas, and that work will commence within about a month or less than 2 months. So the process actually works, and for that phase, this—
How can we make sure that the construction starts before the vulnerable spaces collapse?
We are working with our staff right now to design various sections, and you probably know those sections, 89th to 90th, 114th to 115th, 117th, and 125th are all the areas we have identified. It so happens that while we were preparing design for these packages, the area we identified as being vulnerable actually collapsed. So we know the areas, and work is going to commence to address those critical locations.
And I'll just reiterate that $169 million, I need your full support on that. It was in the City Council budget response, and let the record reflect that most of the money is actually going to go to a district north of mine. And this will benefit the communities of East Harlem, the Upper East Side, and East Midtown. So I think it is a big deal, and it is part of the loop, because you can't have the loop, because if you build from 53rd to 61st, but the rest of it's already fallen in, that's going to be a problem. Along similar lines, my goal in working with you, and I want to thank you, we were able to open about 2,000 square feet at a pier on 90th Street, is to open more park space. I believe you share that goal. And there's a piece of land under the Queensboro Bridge. In other locations under bridges, you have great multi-purpose fields. On Randall's Island, you have soccer on turf, on synthetic turf. I've been told I'm not allowed to say astroturf, but synthetic turf. The community has passed multiple resolutions. Every elected official from our Congress member on down is asking for that space to be a field. In speaking with folks, a lot of folks some are happy that there are 3 months a year additional of availability for the public for six tennis courts. Others have done an analysis and found that now the person who has the sweetheart contract without having to really bid against anyone now has two more courts for three additional months a year. They're going to save about $1 million+ a year on having to take down the bubble and put it back up. So it's a net positive for them. And so is there an opportunity to please return this to the public as a multi-use field that anyone can use year-round without having to pay as much as $200 an
hour? Well, as you know, this is not parkland. It is land owned by the Department of Transportation that has a concession on it. Our goal to the process was to find a pilot program that would open up the site to the public, and we felt the pilot, we'll see exactly how that works. The public now will have access to climate-controlled tennis courts for children, for seniors, that now have access to a space they didn't have access before in its current setting. We will continue to explore how this pilot works before we make a long-term decision in coordination with the Department of Transportation, who's the landowner of that land. And so that's what we committed to do when we met with the community. As you know, that there were somewhat of those for and those against, and we worked with all parties as we consider future use of this Department of Transportation owned land.